Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to see one of the important concept that you need to understand the load flow solution technique. This is one of the key concept for the load flow studies. Bus classification. To do any load flow technique, first you need to identify which type of bus it is. Okay? According to that, we need to choose the equations and perform the load flow solution technique. So let us see what is meant by this bus classification, how many types are there. We know in general, a node means where several lines are interconnected to this. So bus also do the same job. So where you will have n number of transmission lines will be connected to this. Some may be the incoming lines and some may be the outgoing lines. That means where the loads or the generators connected at a particular node will be called as a bus. Second point, each bus will be associated with four different quantities. These four quantities, real power, reactive power, voltage, magnitude and the phase angle. These four quantities play a very important role in the load flow studies. So, each and every node which is present in the network or the power system will be associated with these four quantities. Right? Now, bus classification also will be done by using these four quantities only. Means, out of these four quantities, any two quantities will be specified at any bus. N number of buses if you take in the system, each bus will be specified with any two quantities out of these four quantities. That may be either P and Q or P and the mod V value. Combination of these four quantities only will be known and two more quantities we need to find out. That means first we need to identify which bus is the given bus. Okay, then you will come to know which quantities we need to find out. Then we can find out those quantities. Now let us see the next point. That is what I have told you. Out of these four quantities, that is real power, reactive power, voltage, magnitude and the phase angle, we will be knowing only two quantities. Remaining two quantities will be unknown to us. So those quantities we need to find out here. Depending upon the quantities that have been specified at each bus, these buses are classified into three categories. So majorly to say, these buses are classified into only two categories. But we will see what is that other one more, because we are telling this as a three total categories. So let us see the bus classification. So as I said, the buses are represented in three different categories. One is a load bus, another one is generator bus. Okay, so strictly to speak, we have only two different types of the buses. One is the load bus, another one is the generator bus or voltage controlled bus. Now the next bus is slack bus, swing bus or the reference bus. Okay, this slack bus, swing bus is also one of the generator bus. Okay, if you have a four generators, so one of the generator bus only will be called as a slack bus or swing or the reference bus. That means this slack bus is also one of the generator bus. Okay, according to that, if you see, we have only two different types of buses. One is the load bus, another one is the generator bus or the voltage controlled bus. Now, why we have taken this slack bus or swing or the reference bus, we will see a little why. Another name of this load bus is the PQ bus and another name of generator or the voltage controlled bus will be called as a PV bus. Now, I will explain you why we are calling the load bus as a PQ bus and generator bus as a PV bus. These are the short notations, okay? Now, why we got these names means, I told you, right, out of the four quantities, only two quantities will be specified. Based on the specified quantities, we have taken this different categories of the buses. Okay. Now, let us see what and all details will be provided for this slack bus. What type of bus it is and what are the quantities specified for that particular bus and what are the quantities that we have to calculate. So, as I told you, we have three different buses. The first is a load bus or the PQ bus. We know, as the name suggested, the PQ, the specified quantities will be the real power and the reactive power. Now, if you say what are the quantities left over out of these four quantities, so we will consider here real power, reactive power, voltage magnitude and the phase angle, right? Now, if you take the P and Q are specified, means what are the quantities that we need to find out? We have to find out voltage magnitude and the phase angle. So, that we will represent here, voltage magnitude and phase angle. Similarly, if you take the PV bus, that is a second bus, is a generator bus, or simply you can call it as a PV bus. For that, the real power and the voltage magnitude already specified. So, the unknown quantities will be the reactive power and the phase angle. So, we need to find out the reactive power and the phase angle, or you can say that the load angle. The specified quantities for the reference bus are mod V and the load angle del, and we need to find out the real power and the reactive power. Okay. The specified quantities are mod V and del. We need to find out the P and Q value. So, this complete classification of buses is very, very, very important. So, first all of you should be in a position to identify, okay, if I take the load bus, which quantities to be specified, which quantities we have to calculate. If it is a PV bus, what and all quantities we need to calculate. So, if you remember this much, it is very, very easy to understand the load flow solution technique. Now, I have told you, I will explain about this slack bus, swing or the reference bus. Let us see what is the importance and what is the significance of the slack bus. Why we have to keep, you know, one of the generator as with a special name and with a special function. Now, let us see the significance of the slack bus. Generally, why we will keep this slack bus means, whenever we are performing the load flow studies, we won't be knowing the losses which are happening in the system until we complete the load flow solution, right? So, because of this reason, what we are doing is, we are keeping one of the generator exclusively to take care about the losses. Okay. Actually, this slack bus or swing bus will not take any actual load. Okay. Whatever the load that we have, this generator will not supply any load to the consumer. That particular generator is meant only to supply the transmission losses which are happening during the load flow solution. In general, the phase angle representation for this slack bus will be taken as a reference value. Okay. So, I hope you have understood well how many types of buses are there in the system and what are the known quantities and what are the unknown quantities at each bus. I hope it is clear. Thank you.